Hello and welcome to Ed Burns Arena here in Arlington, where we have your Ashland slash Medway Mustangs girls hockey taking on Arlington in the first round of the girls state division two preliminaries. Here we have Arlington seated number 6 and Ashland Medway seated number 27 as we have the puck drop. And it was controlled by Ashland Medway. These Ashland Medway girls had a pretty strong season, going 8 wins, 7 losses, 5 ties. Just over 50%, which qualified them for the playoffs. As that's trapped by the goalie for Ashland Medway, Zoe Ratcliffe, the sophomore. These Arlington girls, meanwhile, have had a much better season, which is why they are seeded 6th. They went 13 wins, 2 losses, and 5 ties. As they control the puck drop in the Ashland zone, around the back of the boards, looking to set up their offense here is Arlington. The shot intercepted by Ashland's defense. But some strong plays from Carolyn Days, the senior for Arlington. He's going to retain possession and a shot on goal. Not going to yield anything. Will certainly be an uphill battle for these Ashland girls as we have a breakaway on the Ashland side of things. The pass over to number 18 and a goal off the rip, scored by Maggie Lester. The forward sophomore for Ashland Medway. And that is a statement. We are a minute and 20 seconds into the game here. And Maggie Lester from Ashland. What a statement from Ashland here in this Arlington arena. Pretty packed stands on either side for this playoff matchup. That was a beautiful 2-on-2, and the leading offensive puck handler made the right pass over to Lester, and she hit top right corner, all net. And this Ashland defense is being aggressive, pushing up on the Arlington wings. This Ashland defense seems to be in the right spots at the right time. Arlington can't really get their offense started. And that is hit into the Arlington zone. It's going to be icing. Going to get some subs from the Arlington and Ashland Medway side of things here. I'm Connor Donovan, of course, joined by my cameraman, Tom Hamilton. So we're going to get the puck drop here. A quick shot from Arlington doesn't go. Saved by the right leg of Zoe Ratcliffe, who's going to have a big game ahead of her. Certainly, on paper, a disadvantageous matchup for Ashland, but they're trying to rewrite that narrative as we're not even 5 minutes into the first period here, and Ashland is up 1-0, and they're on a break right now. That was Lester again with the shot. But Ashland looking to set up some offense now of their own now. Ashland playing hard defense here. And they come away with a steal. There's Lester in the corner. Passes out, but it's off the mark, and here's going to be an advantage for Arlington. But the puck's going to be trapped by Ratcliffe. Back in the Ashland zone where we've spent most of the game thus far. Puck drop controlled by Arlington. They try for a shot on net. It doesn't go. But Ashland again comes away with a breakaway. And the aggressive defense is going to put Arlington back into their own zone. And that forces Arlington to be called for icing here. That was some heads-up defense from Haley McLeod on the Ashland Medway side of things. Now this girls' hockey team is technically the Medway Mustangs, but they are actually a combination of four different Tri-Valley League teams, Medway, Holliston, Millis, and Ashland. But I guess the main makeup of the roster consists of Ashland girls and Medway girls with a few Holliston girls and Millis girls sprinkled in. So they are, at least in the MIAAs on the website, it says Medway Ashland when designating who exactly this team is representing town-wise. We're going to have some wholesale substitutions here as we're just about 5 minutes through the first period. Ashland still with a 1-0 lead over sixth-seeded Arlington. Arlington has looked pretty good offensively. Just haven't found the right shot or picked the right spot yet. From the wing, there's a shot blocked by McLeod, by Ratcliffe, and a scramble for the puck. Ashland comes away with it. I passed just a little too long for Grace Killman. And the push up by Arlington here. Seems like the operative strategy for Ashland Medway here is to trap the puck whenever possible and just take the puck drop and play some aggressive defense whenever they can, which has been working for them. Scramble on the boards. Ashland comes away with it. Lester tried to drive it up, but it was snatched by Arlington. But we have a 3-on-2 here. Arlington in transition trying to get back. Pass was off the mark. But the Ashland defense is where they should be to retain possession offensively. And the shot here from number 4 for Ashland. The shot doesn't go. But a good attempt from Ashland Medway as we're going to get some subs on both sides. And a surprising amount of this game has actually been played in the neutral zone because of Ashland's very aggressive defense on Arlington's wings. Instead of letting them kind of pass around and look for a shot, they're pushing up on the puck, kind of putting themselves out of position, playing, I guess, what in basketball we would label a man defense rather than a zone defense. And here's a breakaway for Ashland. And the shot off the Arlington goalie, Allison LaBarge. And Arlington is going to come away with possession here. Number 10 for Arlington, going to take it herself. Gabriella Russo, one of the offensive stars for this Arlington team. That shot went off the skate of Lauren Murphy for Ashland Medway. But Arlington still with control, trying to push the goal. Doesn't amount to anything. Ashland is just warding off every single attack that Arlington throws at them at this point. But if they keep giving Arlington these opportunities, you got to wonder if one of these is just going to find the right spot. So that one hits the ref. Ashland comes away with the off the ref puck. The possession war at this time kind of firmly being won by Arlington, but it's kind of going both ways at this point. Probably a 40-60 or a 45-55 split in favor of Arlington as we're about halfway through the first period. Ashland Medway leading Arlington 1-0 after a fantastic breakaway goal by Maggie Lester. And it's a 1v2 here, and the Arlington could not control it. But Arlington getting back, setting up their offense and taking a shot. Arlington definitely leading in the shot attempts department. The quick shot from Marlene Connolly doesn't go. Around the back of the boards, Arlington fights for control, and they have it. Ashland stops a shot, sends it to the other end of the rink for icing. It's coming back. 6 minutes to go in the first period here. Ashland Medway not lacking in the seniors department either. And I'm told by the coach that's mainly who we're going to see in terms of personnel, as we got a big check on the boards in the neutral zone. But yet again, it's coming back. Bunch of seniors for this Ashland squad. We have Izzy Larsh, Lauren Norton, Bryn Moriarty. And Bryn Moriarty, I'm told, is an all-star caliber defensive player. But Ashland also not lacking in the young talent department, as they have a couple pretty standard freshmen who sub in or get the start on occasion. Ashland driving now on the backboards, fighting for the puck. This Arlington defense been also kind of an unsung hero. The only reason Ashland is up right now is because of a strong breakaway, but other than that, the Arlington defense hasn't budged. Fight just outside the crease. Arlington was looking for the rebound and the putback, didn't get it. Strong shot blocked by the Ashland wing and pushed across the neutral zone. Some quick subs for both teams, and a whistle. Not sure if a girl lost a glove or something, but we're going to be dropping the puck in the neutral zone. Controlled by Arlington. But this aggressive Ashland defense, Lester comes out and pesters the puck. Oh, and that gets by the Ashland defense. Arlington skating harder right now. It's going to be on the backboards. around to Arlington's wing. They're looking to set up their consistent offense here. And here's a break from Ashland, trying to get by this Arlington defense. Arlington showing fundamentally why they are the sixth seed. They are so consistent in their offense and defense. As we're nearing the end of this first period. Subs for both teams. Lines are changing. That's going to be controlled by Bryn Moriarty. And a quick shot. Bryn Moriarty turns it over. And Arlington takes control. And a quick shot into the middle left corner of the goal. So Ratcliffe couldn't get it. Couldn't get the stop on that one. I believe the goal was actually scored by number 15, Michaela Doherty. And she is quite the offensive powerhouse for Arlington in her own right. A crucial mistake for the Ashland defense here. And we're tied up 1-1. Been a pretty thrilling game as we're nearing the end of the first period. That icing call was against Arlington, so we're gonna be in the Arlington zone here. And chalk that one up. It was, in fact, Michaela Doherty that scored that goal off the putback. Ooh, almost a tough shot for the Ashland goalie, Zoe Ratcliffe, to handle yet again. Arlington probably looking to go on the attack at this point. Lester getting doubled on the boards. But an errant pass goes right to an Ashland wing. Nothing comes of it, though, or forward, I should say. Lester again tries to scoop it around, doesn't go. How about Maggie Lester? It's been an offensive gem for Ashland in this game so far. But Arlington with numbers here, trying to juke the defender. Tries to go right, but is just wide. Arlington maintains possession, back on offense. Puck in the neutral zone, controlled by Arlington. Not really a pass-happy team there. They're all confident in their abilities to drive and score. But at this point, looking for the pass outside, back in. Back around, controlled by number 12, Shea O'Day. On the wing. Arlington just meticulously looking for their spot. And Ashland defense has been good at warding them off, but can't really come away with a definitive steal or possession here. 1 minute left in the period. As Arlington got tired from that long offensive possession. Stop by Ratcliffe. Arlington needed to make some wholesale substitutions, but one of their offensive players out there stayed out there and managed to get a shot off. Battle on the boards right now. Arlington comes away with it. And the goal just kind of slides in. That's what you get. Arlington's ruthless offense just keeps going and going and going. They make substitutions. They can still put up shots. And the kind of bend, don't break mentality of the Ashland defense just kind of broke there a little bit. They put up with an offensive onslaught from Arlington for about 3.5 minutes. And finally just let a goal slide by. 2-1. Arlington takes the lead as we're just about to end the first period here. And that's going to do it. 2-1 as we head into the second period. A pretty big and commanding second half of that period for Arlington. They realized what they were doing wrong and adjusted almost immediately after a quick breakaway goal by Ashland in the first minute and a half of the game. Now we're going to take a quick break here, but we'll be back shortly with the second period of action. Keep it locked here on WACA-TV. And we're back for the second period of action here at Ed Burns Ice Rink here in Arlington. Arlington took a 2-1 lead late in the first period, mainly because of their stellar offensive performance and just basically their never give up attitude against this bend don't break Ashland defense. They just kind of broke. The goals thus far scored by, on the Arlington side, scored by Michaela Doherty and Madeline Kropelka. And on the Ashland side, that quick breakaway goal in the first minute and 30 seconds scored by Maggie Lester. But since then, Ashland has been, aside from a shot here or a shot there, relatively quiet on the offensive end. Seems like the main weakness that Arlington has is that they're tough. It's tough for them to get back in transition, as off the rip we get a huge shot into the chest of Zoe Ratcliffe, who, as I said, needs to have a pretty big game for Ashland to pull this one out. Certainly the underdogs in this matchup here. Ashland seeded 27th to Arlington 6th. As we get the puck drop within the Ashland zone here. Right to an Arlington forward. But possession changes again. The possession battle, I would say, was pretty cleanly won by Arlington, especially by the end of that first quarter. Had a pretty solid 3-minute stretch of just straight offense as Ashland tries to lob a shot on goal. Maybe a chance for them to set up some offense here, something they haven't really done all that often. Shot inside, but is quickly turned over. I was going to say good hands by number 4, Emily Ilfanger. Infanger, excuse me. But I don't know what you call it. You don't say, like in basketball, you say good hands when someone plays good defense, but good stick work, I guess. As Arlington has possession here. Long shot on goal is wide and up left. Another shot. The way that Zoe Ratcliffe moved her stick, I thought it was going left, but she made the right call and gets the save. Already two big saves for Zoe Ratcliffe here as we start off the second period. Arlington coming out of the locker room just as relentless with their offense. But Ashland seems to be just as relentless with their aggressive defense. Arlington doesn't care as they lob another shot on goal. Doesn't go. And on the money pass over to number 12, Shea O'Day, who's had a pretty good defensive performance thus far. And the shot from O'Day is blocked by the Ashland defense. And a quick breakaway, number 22 for Ashland. Laura Norton takes a shot but it does not go. Laura Norton, one of the seniors for this Ashland squad, Ashland Medway, I should say. And Ashland Medway also trying to get, I guess, revenge. Not really revenge, but they are here instead of the boys team, which had a stellar playoff performance last year, as we have a attempted 1-2 pass to shoot from Arlington, but it is swallowed up by Zoe Ratcliffe. But the Ashland boys hockey team last year made a huge deep run into the playoffs, but was ultimately stopped by Hopkinton in the Division III state finals. This Medway Ashland girls team trying to see if they can replicate such a performance. And speaking of which, Hopkinton on the boys' side of things is just a powerhouse, while the Ashland hockey program kind of fell off a little bit by comparison this year. The Hopkinton program has arguably gotten even better. They had a 19-1 record this year, and they are the first seed in the Boys South Division III. So, I mean, it's going to be they were the eighth seed last year, and it's going to be tough to stop them this year if you are a competing South Division III squad. I think Hopkinton is kind of a behemoth there. But Arlington with possession, another brilliant save by Zoe Ratcliffe. She is putting in work in this second period. Four saves, maybe five, recorded for her already. But that's what this Ashland defense has either wanted to do or been forced to do. Just kind of play good, aggressive defense the whole time on this Arlington squad. Shot goes wide left, controlled by Ashland. But an Arlington forward, right place, right time, maintains possession. Pass outside to Kropelka. She couldn't handle it, but she already has a goal on the night, so she's definitely someone to watch out for. Fight for the puck on the boards. Arlington comes away with it. Controlled by Grace Corsetti around the back. No one's there though, so Ashland's got it. They pass it into the neutral zone. Ashland tried for a quick breakaway, but nothing came of it. So Arlington defense just swallows up breakaways at this point. No icing call on that, because an Ashland Medway player touched it. A hard shot off of number 15, Jenna Fitzsimmons, who's one of the starting freshman for this Ashland squad. Ooh, that breakaway gets lost in transition by Allison Pigott? But she skated fast and just lost the handle on that one. Cross rink pass finds its recipient. This is solid offense from Arlington right now, as they've been so solid all game. But an errant pass results in a breakaway, but the defense is back there. Not going to let Lightning strike twice in the same spot. Quick shot from Emile Infanger. Arlington back on offense here. Another save from Ratcliffe. It's a good shot by Molly Connolly, but Ratcliffe has been so consistent in this second period. Radcliffe, the Medway sophomore here. Arlington comes away and fires a shot. And chalked that one up as another save. Ashland gets possession of the dropped puck. But this Arlington team's so fast at getting back in transition. And suddenly they got the advantage now. Nice shot from Carolyn Days. Doesn't go. And a fight in the neutral zone. Arlington decides to take a rip of a shot. Can't get the put back, but they maintain possession. Outside to Grace Corsetti. Ooh, almost an amazing pass inside, but Arlington can't find the recipient. Corsetti again, passes across the ice. Tries for the inside shot. The fans are mad about something on that. This great puck movement from Arlington here. This Ashland defense is scrambling to close out to whomever has the puck. And again, here's another offensive onslaught from Arlington. It's tough for Ashland to deal with for minutes on end without subs. Ooh, tried for the wraparound, didn't go. Again, good defense from Radcliffe. Or it could be Jenna Shutt. I just realized that there are two goalies listed here, and I can't see the number. So this amazing defensive performance could be attributed to either one. Arlington still in control. But elects to throw that one against the backboards in order to get some subs out there. And the Ashland bench is stoked about that as they reset it to the Arlington zone and get some subs in there as quickly as they can. An errant pass goes over to Katie Cruz, number 10. But Arlington taking their time. Looking for the open forward. Both forwards hit the deck on that one. Ooh, quick inside pass to the shot. Doesn't go. Arlington coach whistling for some subs. Ooh, an Ashland inside pass almost went in for the wraparound on the crossbar. But a sloppy handle results in an Arlington possession, and they're going to take advantage. About 4:30 left to go in this second period. It's gone by with a barely even a whistle, it feels like. Ooh, tries for the putback, Arlington does, and it doesn't go. Ashland gets possession out of it, but they throw it into the Arlington zone and take some subs. That's the thing about this relentless, oppressive Arlington offense is that it just tires out the defense so much that even if they do manage to get a breakaway, they're too tired to do anything with it. They got to send some subs in. It's kind of a floater shot from the Ashland forward is swallowed up by Allison LaBarge. LaBarge hasn't had to do too much work tonight. But now that it's in the Arlington zone, we have Bryn Moriarty taking the faceoff here, and maybe Ashland can do something with it. Arlington struggling to get it out of the zone. This is where Ashland is good in the neutral zone. A shot. But Infanger's shot doesn't go. This Ashland defense in the neutral zone is so potent. It's where they're shining right now. Just not letting Arlington get into their zone. And a shot from number 15 is quickly swallowed up by Allison LaBarge. The freshman Jenna Fitzsimmons took that shot for Ashland Medway. And we're going to have a couple subs here. Danny Moriarty, the freshman forward from Ashland, is going to take this one. Arlington putting it over the neutral zone, taking a one-footed shot off balance, and Ashland's going to get the rebound. Katie Cruz is playing some physical offense to try to maintain possession of that puck, but a lot of Arlington defense there, and she just can't maintain it. Arlington setting up their offense, tries for the inside pass. Around the back of the boards, it just seems like Arlington is in the right place at the right time at every opportunity. Grace Corsetti on the left wing as she's been most of the night. Hasn't had too many shots, but has been a pretty prime distributor for Arlington as they try to penetrate inside. Oof, a quick shot in the melee is just high. But again, Arlington gets the rebound and they elect to just keep running the clock out. A shot from Corsetti. That was wide right. Arlington still with possession here. On the corner boards, inside pass. Oh, it was basically a one-on-one. And it looks like it is Jenna Schutt who's been in net this whole time. That was a fantastic defensive effort from Jenna Schutt. A gorgeous inside pass to an Arlington forward, but she couldn't get the shot to go where she wanted. And Fanger, proven to be one of the fastest skaters on this team, tried for the shot in the right corner. And a hard check onto Bryn Moriarty. Don't believe there's a whistle on that. 40 seconds left in the second period, and we are still at 2-1 here in Arlington. It's a good outlet pass to Moriarty, but she can't do anything with it. Ashland maybe just trying to run out the clock right now. They don't want it in their zone. They don't want to get even more tired. They just want to run out the clock, go into the locker room, and formulate a strategy for this third period so they can tie this game up, and that's going to do it. The score remains 2-1 as we head into the third period. Some big defensive plays from Jenna Schutt and Bryn Moriarty to close this one out, but largely it's been all Arlington. Stick with us here on WACA-TV as we bring you the conclusion of the game coming up. And we are back for the third and final period of action here in Arlington. And there's the star of the game for Ashland Medway. Jenna Schutt has been lights out, as it were. She's only allowed two goals on a multitude of shots. And as my cameraman put it during the break, very aptly, she is the reason that Ashland Medway is still in this game. Because this Arlington offense has been as ruthless as ever as we're about to get the puck drop here, to the point where that second period, just kind of flew by just because Arlington had it and was passing around in the zone for so long. Ashland going to ice it off the rip. They're going to play some aggressive defense. This is where Ashland's been best. They try for the wraparound. Doesn't work out. But a nice aggressive play to start out the third period here. It came from Lauren Norton, the first string forward. She plays defense. And here's Arlington's bread and butter here. They elect to give it up a little early, though. And Ashland has just got to do what they do best. And what they've been doing best in this game is pressuring from the defensive side in the neutral zone, or just before the neutral zone. If Arlington manages to retain possession in their own zone, it's been a force for them to be able to get it out. That was fantastic defense there from Molly Connolly. Ashland thought they had the advantage on the breakaway there, and Connolly just comes out of nowhere and gets the puck from behind on that one. Ashland controlling the faceoff here. Trying to see if they can get some offense started. It looks like a nope. They do retain possession, though. Bringing it past the neutral zone. And it is quickly stripped by Arlington. Arlington going to make some subs here. And that seems to be one of Arlington's MOs, is while they're making subs, they just keep the pressure on with whomever they're going to leave out there. It's the second shot they've taken while the rest of their team is just coming off the bench. Quick shot from Devin Norman. But again, Arlington is just so consistent at grabbing the rebounds from whatever shot they put up. And just resetting the offense, finding the open person, and making the right hockey play. But there's Schutt again. She's got to be at least in above 15 in terms of saves in this game. Because Arlington has not been shy about shooting the puck. And she's just, after the first period, she has been just unstoppable. After a failed icing attempt, Ashland actually comes away with it. In the zone, tries for an inside pass, doesn't go. Arlington with the control here. Ooh, a quick dangle maneuver there. Ooh, that is a brutal one if you're Ashland. 3 minutes into the period. Quick goal scored by, I believe that was number 9, Lauren Murphy. One of the captains for this Arlington squad. It was a nice shot from around the red circle. And it flew right into the middle right side of the net. Shutt was there to try to deny it with the glove, but it just got right by her glove. Ashland Medway on the attack. The backhanded pass inside and a goal. Goal scored by, I believe, Danny Moriarty. And Ashland, just as it was looking like a challenge for them, Danny Moriarty comes in. Off the bench, Danny Moriarty, the freshman Ashland forward, comes off the bench and brings it back to a one-goal game. Two goals scored within 30 seconds of each other. Not something you see too often here. And that could be the spark that this Ashland Medway team needs to really jumpstart their offense and start putting some shots on the net. Because that is an area where they have been sorely lacking in this game. Arlington passing it around the back of the boards here. Oh, but the pass goes errant. And we're back in the neutral zone. Ashland keeping up the pressure. They are certainly jazzed after that goal. And here we go. One on two for Ashland. Decides to bring it to the back. Fight on the backboards. Tries for that inside pass, but there's no one there this time. Arlington with possession. Bringing it up. They shove it to the backboard in order to get some subs out. Both teams vying for position in the neutral zone. Ashland's aggressive defense in the neutral zone warrants a triple team on the puck. And Ashland has been certainly a lot more active in both their offense and defense ever since that goal got scored. A shot from number 18, not caught, so it's rebounded, but Arlington's got the control here. Maggie Lester, who already has a goal on the day, tried for that shot. We're 5 minutes through the third period here. 3-2 with Arlington in the lead. But Ashland's not going to go quietly. Ashland also getting a little bit more physical on defense here. Markedly different from the first period. Tied up in the right wing corner there. Looking a lot how we did in the first period where Arlington just can't seem to get the right shot that they need off just because of how aggressively Ashland's being on the defensive end. But the struggle for Ashland, the story of this game for Ashland Medway so far has been the inability to turn that aggressive playmaking defense into offense and then into goals, or even shot attempts at that. Arlington controls the faceoff. Great heads-up defense from, I believe that was Moriarty. Ashland with some numbers on the break here. Nothing comes out of it as Arlington puts the puck in the back of the boards from the neutral zone, takes some subs, and you have a well-rested Arlington line out there right now. Arlington also getting a little bit physical on the boards. It's do or die for both of these teams. Seasons are on the line. This is the preliminary playoffs, and Ashland, I'm sure, is putting up much more of a fight than Arlington expected. Ashland being the 27th seed, Arlington being the 6th seed. And that doesn't stop Ashland from making Arlington work a little bit for it. Again, 3-2 the score. 7 minutes left and a breakaway for Ashland. That's Izzy Larch. Quick shot from Arlington. Goes wide right. And a fight on the right side boards. It's coming down to the wire. A foot race to the puck in the Arlington zone, but it's going to be icing. Maggie Lester couldn't get there in time. The faceoff in the Ashland zone here. It's going to be a big possession for Ashland, or for Arlington, I should say. But as we approach 6.5 minutes to go, time is not Ashland's friend here, as I guess historically it has been since we're the Clockers, but Arlington has been very, very good at wasting time on the offensive end, and that hit the crossbar. I thought it went in and out. That was a gorgeous shot from Fiona Johnson-McDonald, but unluckily hits the crossbar. And I guess luckily if you're an Ashland Medway fan, and also if you're Jenna Schutt. Arlington still with possession, tries for the backhanded inside pass, but fakes it and passes back outside to the wing. Johnson-McDonald again with the shot, doesn't go. Ashland trying to see if they can get some defense started here. Quick shot from Johnson-McDonald again. But Ashland can't even seem to ice it at this point. And yeah, they do. Historically, Ashland has not been able to ice it. Had a tough time getting it out of their zone. Going to get a face-off in Ashland territory here. But Arlington has not taken their foot off the brake here. So we're almost inside 5 minutes. 3-2, Arlington still in the lead here. A fight behind the net. Ashland comes away with it. Over to Jenna Fitzsimmons, who makes the pass to Izzy Larch. But Ashland does not have numbers on the break. They elect to take some subs. And Jenna Schutt just decides to stop that puck rather than passing it off to a teammate. Probably the right decision. You don't want to take a risk like that and make the game farther out of reach than it needs to be, especially with 4:45 remaining here at Ed Burns Ice Rink in Arlington. Ooh, gorgeous deflection from Schutt. Went off her glove. And that shot wide left. Ashland with 2v2 on the break here. Over to Larch. Larch can't control the pass. A fight for it in the neutral zone. A big time check, but no whistle. Arlington taking some wholesale subs here. But this has been the story. Ashland can't seem to get it out of their own zone. Here's Lester again. Lester turns it over. Lester ready and waiting to take the shot. She does. And it is off of Allison LaBarge's leg. Ashland trying to control the puck on the faceoff. Possession switching sides. But an errant pass is going to lead to an Arlington breakaway. They try for the 1-2, but the pass is just a little long. A slap shot from number 13, Fiona Johnson McDonald, who has been a star in this third period for Arlington. Arlington passing it around the wings. The inside pass. Nobody was there, but Arlington tries to do it again. Traffic at the goal inside the crease, but Shutt puts the glove down. Time running out for Ashland Medway here. 3-2 with just over 2 minutes left. Season on the line. A goal would tie it. Fight on the boards. Bryn Moriarty comes away with it. Ooh, aggressive defense in the neutral zone. Almost gives Ashland a breakaway possession on there. Izzy Larsh getting after it. Arlington just wasting all the time they can, even being hesitant to push it up. Because they know how potent that defense is in the neutral zone for Ashland. Minute 30 seconds left. A hard-fought game on both sides here, but on paper, this was not supposed to be as close as it is.
Timeout Medway. Medway takes their timeout.
Ashland Medway taking their timeout with a minute 30 left. Now would be the time to do it. Season is on the line. Head coach Carl Infanger drawing up a play here. Maybe not even drawing up a play, more like giving some words of encouragement. Oh no, looks like he's writing something down on the board there. This is do or die for the Ashland Medway girls hockey team. This is the preliminary round of the girls' state Division II playoffs. Been a hard-fought game on both ends, but we've had some great plays from the likes of, on the Ashland side, we had Maggie Lester and Danny Moriarty with the two goals for Ashland. some great defensive moments from Bryn Moriarty and Izzy Larsh, as well as Emily and Fanger. On the Arlington side of things, we've had some nice shots and positional playmaking from Grace Corsetti. Michaela Doherty has one of the goals. Madeline Krapelka, the other one. And I actually do not know who has that third goal. Might be Carolyn Days, the senior captain for Arlington. But in this third period, a lot of the story has been Fiona Johnson-McDonald for Arlington being so solid in the wing position. And here we have Arlington just playing some keep away at this point. Inside a minute now. Ashland gets possession, though, and they have numbers. They throw it off the back boards. Maybe trying to set up some offense for a last push here in this last minute. A shot from number 22, blocked by Arlington. Another shot, just left. Ashland taking every shot they can. Maggie Lester gets blocked by Arlington defense. 30 seconds left here. Ashland mounting a strong offensive push. One of the strongest they've had all day at this point. Maggie Lester on the wing. They're probably looking for her to take the shot. Some hard defense from Bryn Moriarty. Ten seconds left. It's now or never for Ashland. And icing would do it. But an errant backhanded pass. There's nobody there. Arlington controls the possession. And the clock expires. A tough loss, but an amazing offensive last minute for this Ashland Medway squad. They showed that they can be physical and offensive playing this last period till the very end, and certainly giving sixth-seeded Arlington a run for their money. The final score here is 3-2 from Ed Burns Ice Rink. I'm Connor Donovan. My cameraman was Tom Hamilton. Thanks for watching WACA-TV, and we will see you for the spring sports season.